Smart Omega, and of course, had Jeezy going for this Bruno right here, which was reworked so fine and so well. Nakita natin, ginagamit na to ng marami.
Yes. Well, yung base damage din kasi talaga, even ng course. Isang Bruno is really astonishing damage-wise talaga. Pero actually, iniisip ko kanina, they might be thinking, pwede nating ipasok siguro doon yung Kimi it's because we already have the Gushon. Walang pwedeng mag-burst ka agad doon sa Kimi. Pero they would definitely be taking down the Bruno as their fourth pick dito, ladies and gentlemen. But on the side of the Bren E Pro, are they gonna be using the Masha? I really like that pick. All right. Masha. Actually, this hero, well, ako kasi, ginagamit ko talaga yung Masha. Pero iba ka sa akin. I use the Masha arrival technique. Pero more on the pro scene kasi, ang ginagamit nila, especially on the Masha, same pa rin naman. Push threat. Pero they're more on the flicker side.
Yeah.
Kumbaga, yung arrival kasi, it's more on parang show eh.
Yeah.
Parang you go, parang lipat-lipat ka ng lane. Yes. Pero we'll see dito, ladies and gentlemen. That's gonna be possibly gonna be a Renzo pick. And also, Kagura, Cho, still open here. Haze, sino ba naman ang maaalimot? Haze still has it using his signature Cho.
Haze, you know, building up his name right here. I have arrived with my Chu. At napakagandang last pick for the side of, you know, for our red side right here. Kasi it complements the whole lineup dito eh, para sa ating red side eh. So, pero naman dito sa may side ng Bren, ano, it varies. They have this Kagura, which is a very good damage dealer din naman, alongside with the free hit ng carry dito. Pero I would like to see if the Masha arrival, ginawa nila yun, Masha arrival dito. So
sobrang saya ko, to be honest.
Pwede
na akong hindi, okay na ako. For the whole week, pwede na ako. Ang sobrang saya ko, the National Conference 2, nagamit nila Masha arrival, pwedeng-pwede na.
On the very first day.
Yes. And even Renzo, siya pa yung gagamit, one of the best natin talaga on the position 3. So we'll see kung paano nila si scale up. Kasi ako kasi talaga, to be honest, hindi ko binibuild up yung sarili ka. Whenever I play Masha kasi, it's a single hero na pwede mong dalhin into any lanes.
Yes.
Tapos ang galing din niyang mangbully, man-zone out. But ladies and gentlemen, we're going ahead into our game number 2. Gonna be the best of 3 series in between. Bren E Pro versus PLDT Smart Omega.
Okay, let's have hindi na nga tayo nakapag-quick rundown dahil napaka-intense lagi ng binibigay ng both sides ng team dito. And of course, here, Haze and Carl TZ, sakto nga, you know, just pushing away, shoving minions. And the same thing goes for Bren E Pro. And of course, going back to objective, syempre, hindi na muli gagana ang invading power set. Nagamit mo na the first time eh, so it's not really optimal if you use it the second time. So maganda dito yung both discipline of both teams as they take their respective buffs.
Yes. Pero ito on Bren E Pro dito, as looking on their lineup, medyo slow start sila dito.
Yes.
They really need to look forward, but look at it. Doc Ribu dito going in, dito kay Haze, he might actually get win. Pero dito, flicker in nga, pusakit. Bren, no more will he be able to get through, but Haze, makakatakas pa nga naman din. Pero first blood dito, ex-board, mga kaibigan.
Nangyayari talaga behind the scenes as we're not seeing it.
Yes.
Once again, Fuza Ken here tries to actually get Carl Tizzy, pero knowing the dangers that lurk, alam nung ni Heath and Hajizi na they needed the help. They needed a comrade.
Yes.
So talagang pinuntahan ka agad nila yun with no hesitation sa akin.
And look at Renzo. Kumbaga, dalawa yung nandun sa top. He could be, kayang-kaya niyang ibuli. Pero look at it. Carl TZ with the magic ball coming from Rapplesia. Might, hindi siya makakatakas. But he could be able. Pero yun na nga, namatay pa nga naman din. But Kenji trying to zone out dalawa dito from the side of Bren E Pro. Pero hindi siya dito magwagi, ladies and gentlemen. Papasok pa dito, Rapplesia.
Ayan na nga, Fuza Ken here on standby. Will be going for that ring of order. Si Kenji naiipit ng 3 members ng
Haze.
Now, PLDT Smart Omega and Haze here goes for that knockup right here. But
Fuzakin
still manages to dash away with the help of his lightning bomb. At ayan na nga, with 4 members of Bren E Pro rather, is really a good potential harassment.
Yes, but look at it. So how to zone out nga talaga. Masha rito onto the top lane. Kayang ka. Ito kasi ang mahirap, especially on the Masha side.
Yes.
Lalo na sa mga hindi gumagamit ng Masha. Yung Masha kasi, pag hindi mo siya kayang i-burst down, kaya kanyang i-sustain. It's all because of the life recovery.
And ang maganda sa Masha dito, magaling siya mag-give ng time so that the other members can actually go and aid. kapag ka nasa danger sa lurker. And of course, Brent Ipro, knowing any better, maganda ang position nila for their first hurdle.
Yes, ito ah, medyo nakukuha na rito ng Brent. Ah. Kumbaga, sabi nga natin, this might be the download game nga madalas yes. for the Brent Ipro. Ito, maganda yung start nila rito. Even the momentum coming all lanes dito,
yes.
lamang sila. They even getting the first skill then to Carl TC, the Gushon.
With also the gold cap leading ang Brent Ipro dito, so far so good for their side. And Enter Felicia goes for that knock-up right here. Kenji naiipit ng dalawang members ng ating Brent Ipro here. Oh, and he was actually pushed back towards para hindi siya makapag-tower. Again, it was a free hit. Goes for that carry of your hands though. And Gushon with his incandescence gets the members of Felix Marlon Bergoki here. Gushon successfully going for that double kill. At si Renjio mag-isa lang dito sa ating top side.
Yes, yes. Tapos ito, no? The way nga talaga dito, ang maganda lang nagiging ikot dito ng Brent Ipro is they're always fighting on a 4v3 matchup kasi hindi pwedeng iwan hit dito yung Bruno onto the top lane like a 1v1 situation yes. dito kay Renjo. Pero look at it, trying dito, denying the buff dito ng Brent Ipro. They might actually get it. Carl TC got it. Magic Ball will be used onto the back lane. Tatlo, Kenji rito using the far streak with the kick na manggagaling kay Ace Raflisha. Masyadong makulat, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, and we here go. Last sanity will be used by Kenji to actually go and escape. But once again, with the Ring of Order, gets the throw on time. And Carl TC and Kenji has no choice but to go back.
Yes, ito pa, isa nakakatakot dito sa iya. Fusaken already securing the conceal vest. Kumbaga, it's a lot easier for them to get pick-offs. If ever, either of the two, most of the time, ang pinakamaganda mong kunin, yan nga, like what I've been talking about. But the incandescent will be used, but the damage coming from Doc Rebo will be enough to get the Gushon down.
Yes, this is a potential comeback for the side of Brent Ipro. So long as they keep this momentum going. And with only 4 minutes on the clock, this is going so far. Hayes tries to go in, kicks away Fusaken to actually go in tower dive. Doc Rebo will be here. And with the help of the damage, Kaja will be getting that kill.
Yes, yes. So, nakuha naman dito nila yung objective na gusto nila na kaninang-kanina pa nila gusto that, yung dalawa sa taas. But look at it. Hit will do the 1,000-pounder para makatakas ng Red. But the turtle might get secure dito. Brent Ipro, yes. Kompleto sila dito, ladies and gentlemen.
As much as PLDT Smart Omega would love to contest that turtle, unfortunately, you have said earlier that Masha is very good at sustaining away or zoning out their enemy team. So, maganda ang pinag-execute so far or execution-wise when it comes to using the hero ni Masha dito. And again, going for that knock-up here na stun. Si Pitito, Hurricane Dance going for the escape. But JP will still try to chase but of course decides to disengage. Siyempre, objectives muna ang kanilang priority. Renjo right here na Way of the Dragon. Dito goes for that tower hug but still Cartesi will go for that incandescence and goes for that tower hug kill.
Yes, definitely a nice pick-off nga talaga onto the Masha. Is it yun talaga yung kailangan eh. You really need to burst down the Masha or else he would just stay on the lane. Pero look at it, first second, trying to find dito Coral TC just to get a quick pick off. Roughly siya rito, medyo half online, pero they might try to get the blue buff, pero hindi na to. Haze, looking for a good opportunity para makasipa dito, pero disengage na muna dito, ladies and gentlemen, Brent Ipro.
Yes, this is a good discipline for the side of Kai kasi unti-unti na siyang nagko-collect ng resources niya dahil siya, maganda yung potential damage na nakita natin with only 6 minutes on the clock. It's a very good, nicely done and she's getting it as patient as she can be, you know. So, ayan nga, we can see Fuzakin with the Divine Judgment plus Flicker and Kagar goes for the kill as Haze tries to go with that knock-up pero hindi
wow,
na
out
as many members of a Brent Ipro are on the middle side. Heath and Hajizi here tries to go and actually get for their 8 pero syempre uunahin nila ang Tore para walang sagabal.
Wala nga talagang sagabal pero dito may makakatagal pa nga kaya on the side dito ng PLDT Smart Omega because dito Masha already securing a lot of objective para sa side ng Brent Ipro. Masyadong mabilis talaga bumasag dito. Masha, mga kaibigan, Masha arrival going into our first or actually our Turtle second game dito on the Conference 2.
Yes.
Ito yung isa sa mga gusto ko talagang makita. Bias might be bias for me. Pero yeah, sobrang saya ko na makita talaga tong Masha arrival dito used by Renzo as well. Pero ito ah, kidding aside, Seiya, what gonna be the comeback potential dito na pwedeng magawa dito? PLDT Smart Omega, medyo down sila rito, like at least 8,000 or at least 7,000 gold lead from Bren Ipro.
They have to collect resources as much as possible kasi importante talaga na magkaroon sila ng enough items for potential team fight. And kung team fight ang pag-uusapan natin dito, uunahin na rin dapat nila ang potential damage dealers ng ating Bren Ipro, and one of which is the carry na it will be hard for them simply because this carry is protected. If not protected, meron pa rin siyang damage output na masakit.
Yes. Nakita mo yung, yung map awareness ni Renzo. Kumbaga, pag follow niya, kaya niya ubusin yung creep, pero nakita niya na halos wala sa mapa, nag-back na kagad siya onto the boss. Mm. Tapos yung mga kakampi niya, pinush kagad yung top lane. Pero ito, mahatak dito yung X4. Kenji, nanganganib dito.
And gold cover goes for that killing spree right here. Arrival will be going for that haze. Goes for the flicker. Rhea the Dragon will be used. There's a heat dito. Has to go back but cannot with the help of Master's damage. And carry goes for the free hit.
Yes, that's gonna be the free hit. But Haji will be securing the tier 1 turret onto the middle lane. Pero mukhang wala na yata ditong pakialam. Bren Ipro, they might want to finish this one. Isa na lang ang natitira dito on the side of the PLDT Smart Omega. And Haji might actually go down as well with 1v1 with the Great One. That's gonna be Renzo. Dire-direcho na nga to kung gaano ka one-sided yung first game natin through PLDT Smart Omega. This might be the time, the momentum na manggagaling naman from Bren Ipro.
Last Insanity was used to actually shove away the members of Bren Ipro right here. But the Kagura still will be getting a kill right there as he kills Bruno right here. And I know may na-stun na nga dito. Heat. Kagura goes for the double kill. And look at that damage output. Way of the Dragon will be used to slay that Kufra.
Yes, yes. Meanwhile, lahat ng nangyayaring yon, it's all about Renzo dito just pushing down the bottom lane. Pero the combination, Carl TC, pwede niya rito. Ginamit niya yung thunderclap niya. Medyo risky yun, ha?
Yes,
to be honest,
was.
That's super risky kasi kung pumasok lahat ng mga blades dito ni Carl TC, actually get bursted down.
Yes.
But yes, ladies and gentlemen, 9 minutes into the game, 15-5 yung score natin dito, and at least a 10,000 lead for Bren Ipro.
Yes, and of course, knowing that hindi makakalabas masyado ang PLDT Smart Omega, they will be going and eyeing out for this Lord right here. And of course, PLDT Smart Omega knows better and they will try their best to actually prevent, if not going to contest.
Yes, yes. But medyo kahit papano, no, even lamang dito Bren Ipro, they could act or potentially pwede rin nilang i-burst down kagad yung Lord. They still nire-respeto pa rin nila yung comeback potential dito from PLDT Smart Omega.
Yes, the best thing that Bren Ipro will do here is basically to pick off the members of PLDT Smart Omega first before actually taking the Lord. Pero mukhang pipilitin ang kanito as we see here that the Frisha will be chasing for Heat, and Heat uses his sprint to actually go away to safety, at nang dahil doon, nakuha na nga nila ang Lord para makapag-go and actually push and end the game.
Yes, that Tyrant Revenge talaga. Kasi ang potential nila doon para ma-solve off niya yung Masha or anyone na pumapatay ng Lord is using the Hurricane Dance.
Yes.
Pero roughly siya, with the initiative na with the Tyrant's Revenge, na-cancel niya na kagad yung potential na ma-steal sa kanila yung Lord.
Of course. And like what you said, they are still waiting for that perfect timing kasi they still know the potential comeback ng PLDT Smart Omega. So dahil doon, they will be still sticking to the objectives, and that is going to destroy the towers first. Pero the Divine Judgment and Flicker will be used. Kenji will be flickering away to safety and actually choking them first. But now, looky here. Low and
behold,
naif it's a haze. But Carry goes for the free hit at the Gushon goes for the shot down. Pero hindi pa rin magpapatinag ang ating carry dito as going for that free hit. Going in, goes for that killing spree. Heat, walang choice kundi magback. Kenji though is in grave danger. Last sanity, at natapos na nga nila with the help of the Lord. And ladies and gentlemen, we are going to game number three.
Yes, what exciting. Sobrang conference two, no?
Yes.
The National. Unang dalawang series natin, best of three agad.
Uh-huh.
Kumbaga, all the teams dito talagang naghanda. Naghanda sila going on conference two, and ang ganda.